Problem solving is a skill of identifying the relevant piece of information when faced with massive data. Discarding information that may not be useful to give new information, relating one set of information to another in a different form by using experience, relating new problems to ones we have previously solved. See, in school, we do not teach the solution to every problem, but definitely we prepare our children to solve certain problems. And the way they have solved certain problems now, they may utilize that experience to solve new situations or new problems. That is what is problem solving system. New problems are being solved collectively, but there are problems we do not know which we come across. Okay, so there we may utilize our previous experience and solve those problems effectively. Creativity and innovation. Creativity refers to new way of seeing or doing things and includes four components: fluency, generating new ideas; flexibility, shifting perspective easily; originality, conceiving of something new; elaboration, building on others' ideas. See, every time you cannot be creative enough that you have original ideas. If somebody gave you idea, you can elaborate on that. You cannot be original every time. You should be flexible enough to shift from perspective easily. I thought of one solution, but when I started working on it, I found that it is not going to work. So I was flexible enough to take idea of somebody else or my own idea, where I changed my previous idea and I worked upon new idea. Innovative skills means skills for thinking creatively to develop something new, unique, improved, distinctive. Collaboration, I had been discussing this. Collaboration is the ability to effectively work together with others. This skill involves working together while taking action, respecting others' needs and perspectives, and contributing to accepting the finality. See, what happens, say, I'm just taking one example. I am head of department of one subject. Okay. So, it is not necessary whatever I am saying is the only thing which is correct. If from my department, some other is giving some idea where we can work collaboratively, okay, that should be accepted by us unless that idea is real bad. Okay, so that is the ability to effectively work together. This way you will have better team and your team will be fully involved because you are doing what? You are involving them in your project. Collaboration helps to develop interest and fun in teaching learning process. It effectively broadens the cultural, social and environmental boundaries and helps a child to understand social and environmental concerns better. Communication refers to the ability to express one's opinions, desires, needs, apprehensions, etc. oneself appropriately, verbally and non-verbally. It is not necessary that communication should be done verbally. It could be non-verbally also. Information literacy, media literacy, technology literacy. These skills involve the ability to access information traditionally or digitally. Media and technology to understand and critically evaluate different aspects of content and information and create and communicate effectively. Flexibility and adaptability refers to a person's ability to change his actions and steps taken by him according to a new situation and efficiently facing an unprecedented situation without compromising on ethics and values. Adaptability can be defined as creating modifications or changes in oneself to suit the new environment for students, these can be understood as the skills required to be flexible and adaptive to the situation around them and find the best possible solution to move forward despite adverse conditions. Leadership and responsibility. Leadership is the ability to lead a team and be capable of effective team management to handle world challenges. To these skills, personal qualities such as perseverance, being committed and responsible, resilience and self-confidence are developed. Also, how to foster a commitment to lifelong learning is developed. Being responsible means being a good and effective, sensitive leader. Be aware of the important social and national issues that may have an impact on social and national issues. Be aware of our fundamental duties and rights and embed the core democratic values of India and try to live by them. Initiative and self-direction. Initiative skill involves the ability to begin a task independently. It helps the child to build his or her own path of development. Self-direction is a skill to work with integrity on self-motivation and taking initiative. Productivity and accountability. I have discussed almost all skills which I mentioned, which are required for 21st century. Productivity in the student can be understood as fulfillment of any task within a given time period. Accountability can be understood as feeling responsible for any task done. Developing these skills in or among students helps them to work effectively and also make them reliable for other peers and by being accountable for their actions. Social and cross-cultural interaction. These are the skills to communicate, work collaboratively and effectively in diverse social and cultural environments. Now, again, why do we need 21st century? Learning is considered complete and holistic only when a student is able to effectively perform and fulfill his or her responsibilities and duties towards self, school, family, society, and above all, the nation. The ultimate goal of any educator or institution is to enable today's students to be a good citizen and a responsible human being who is well aware of his potential and competence. Simply teaching to test or learning for exam is not meant to help any student to deal with complex situations in the outer world. 21st century skills are key to empowerment of children and adolescents to deal with the issues and concerns related to their life. We as educators need to equip our children to experience a number of feelings which are related to their growth and development from childhood to adolescence and beyond. Due to rapid economic and social change, schools have to prepare students for jobs that have not yet been created. Technologies that have not yet been invented and problems that we don't yet know will arise. So to meet these challenges, we need to prepare our children for 21st century skills. Thank you very much for patiently listening to me. Now, if you have certain queries, you can send your queries one by one in the chat box. I'll try to respond to your